Hi, and welcome to this Tech Insights video. My name is Mary, and I'm an application engineer here at IFM Effector. In today's video, we're going to go over how to add trends into your visualization using CODESYS and our industrial display controllers. So let's get started. In our previous video, we showed you how to pull in the process data for your sensors. You can see this in my Program Master 1 as an example. I will now show you how to trend this process data using a visualization. You will first go to where it says Application, and you will right-click and go to Add Object and select Visualization. Here you will give it a meaningful name, such as Trends, and press Add. Next, you will go to your Visualization Toolbox tab and select Special Controls. Here you will drag the trend into your visualization area. On the next tab that appears, you will select the task window, and you will select Trend Recording Task and press OK. You then have your Properties tab over on the right-hand side, and here you can change your X and Y position, as well as your width and height. I'm going to set mine for 800 by 400, and the X position to 0, and the Y position to 20. And I'm going to use these settings because I know this is what works for my CR display. I will then go back into the visualization toolbox, and in the special controls tab, there is a legend that you can drag into your visualization. And again, you have your properties on the right-hand side that you can select. And then if you go back into your visualization toolbox and go into the date and time controls tab, you will select your time range picker and drag this into your visualization as well. Now in your device tree, you can see the Trend Recording Manager, as well as the Trends_Trend1 Recording. You can give this a meaningful name by highlighting it and then holding down the mouse button. For this example, I'm going to change it to Process Values. For our example, we want to trend the real pressure and temperature process values. To do this, you need to add the values to your trend recording. We will do this by opening our Process Values trend window and clicking on Add Variables. The three dots to the right of the variable window you will select, and you will navigate to your program. You will do this by expanding Application, and my program name is Program Master 1, and then I will go to the function block of the process value I want to grab. I will go to the PI2798 function block, and I will navigate to where the R pressure value is. In the description, I will give this a name and select Enter. And a pop-up box will appear, and you can just select Yes. You will then repeat this process for the temperature process values by selecting Add Variable again. To the right, you will select the three dots. You will navigate to your function block, and I will select the R temperature and give it a meaningful name. Next, we are going to go back into our trend visualization. Here we are going to change the names of the three elements that we added to this visualization to give them meaningful names for easier configuration down the road. First, we will click on the trend element. And here we are going to change the element name to Process Values Trend. You will then go to where it says Trend Recording, and you will drop down the drop-down window and select Process Values, which is the name of the trend recording we created earlier. Next, we are going to click on the legend element, and here next to element name, we will give it the name Process Trend Legend. And finally, we will go to where it says Attached Element Instance, and we are going to type in the element name that we just gave to the trend element. So here we will type in Process Values Trend. And then next, we want to change the maximum number of rows to 2, and the maximum number of columns to 1. Next, we are going to click on the time range picker element. Here we are going to change the element name to time trend selector. And next we are going to put the trend element name into the attached element instance. The trend element name is process values trend. Next, we are going to click on the create new button 3 times to add different time windows. These windows can be set to any time frame. For my example, is going to be 5 seconds, 30 seconds, and 5 minutes. Here you want to make sure the provide all selection is checked, because this will allow you to zoom into the trend to look at different time window scales. Next, we are going to go back to the trend element to assign the legend and time range picker to the trend. Here we will go to where it says time range picker and type in the time range picker element name, which is time trend selector. And next we will go to the legend and type in the legend element name, which is process trend legend. Next, we are going to click on the trend element and we are going to right click and select configure trend display settings. Here we will click on our Y axis and we are going to select fixed, and we are going to change the minimum and maximum from 0 to 15. Then we will select description and we are going to change this to PSI because this will be the Y axis for our pressure sensor. Once we have changed that, we are then going to add another Y axis and we are going to select description and we are going to change this to F for degrees Fahrenheit for our temperature sensor. So after you have made those changes, you can select OK. You are then going to right click on the trend again, and you are going to select Edit Trend Recording. Here you will select each of your process data values, and then where it says attached Y-axis, you are going to assign the correct Y-axis that we just created. So for our pressure element, we will select PSI, and for our temperature element, we will select degrees Fahrenheit. So now let me take you to our actual CR display and show you the trend that we have just created. So here you can see our CR display with the process values updating in the trend that we created in CODESYS. It is currently set to update and show the values over a 5-second interval. For example, if I touch the temperature sensor with my hand, you can see the green values begin to increase. Similarly, if I take the pressure sensor and touch the measuring cell on the pressure sensor, you can see the pressure either increase or decrease depending on how hard I press. You can also have the display show in different time intervals. For example, if I select the 5-minute interval, you can now see the full process data over that 5-minute interval section. So that concludes this Tech Insights video on creating a trend in your CODESYS software using our industrial display controllers. As always, you can check out our website for helpful information on any of our products. Feel free to contact us at info.us@ifm.com or call into 1-800-441-8246 to speak with somebody who can assist you. Thank you for your time and have a great day.